Welcome to Vocabulary TV. This is our 24th video on word roots in English vocabulary. The theme for this video is the Latin root nat and nasc, which mean birth or to be born, and several words and phrases as seen hanging on the tree branches can be easily memorized using this root connection. As a matter of fact, there are so many words with this root that one list is barely enough to cover them all. The easiest of the words to grasp from this root is natal. Natal is an adjective that describes the place or time of someone's birth, like someone's natal household could be in Delhi. By extension, prenatal is something that relates to the time of pregnancy or before birth. Like one might observe the prenatal development of a child through an ultrasound scan. Once a child is born, in the period immediately after birth, till about 28 days, it could be called a neonate, which literally means newly born. The first 4 weeks is called the neonatal period. And postnatal is again one word denoting or relating to the period after birth. Special emphasis in this period is on the postnatal care of the child and the mother. Next, we have a very popular word, which is innate. The word literally means be born into and describes a quality that exists in a person or animal from the time he or she is born. It can even describe something that exists as a basic part or the basic nature of something or someone. To be short, innate describes the inborn or natural qualities of someone. For example, I can say that this boy has an innate sense of music. Our next word is naïve. If one is naïve, one is as innocent and unexperienced as on the day one was born. Now, interestingly, this word can be used in both positive and in slightly negative connotations. According to a dictionary, a person who shows a lack of experience, wisdom, or judgment could be called naïve. So could a person who is childlike and innocent. And a related word is naïveté, which refers to the quality of being naïve. An example sentence for both words would be, in the movie Enchanted, a rather naïve fairy tale princess is sent to the real world to experience its horrors, but she ends up charming others with her naïveté and pure-heartedness. But perhaps the most common word based on the root is the word nation and its derivatives. The word nation stands for a group of people connected by a common origin or descent. For the people of a nation, the national interests come first. We take pride in the fact that we are Indians, that is to say our nationality is Indian. Then there are words like nationalism, international and multinational. And by the way, when the country gives citizenship to a foreign born, that process is called naturalization, which is another word derived from the root. Now, if you belong to a particular place by birth, you would be called a native of that place. Like we can see an African native posing in this picture. Though the term can very well be used to describe plants and animals which are indigenous to that place. For example, African elephants, known to have large ears, are called so because they are a native of Africa. A related word is nativity, which is a noun meaning a belonging to by birth. Another common derived word is nature, which I guess every English speaker knows about. Nature as we know it is the collective body of plants, animals, landscapes, etc. and is the essence of this word. Anything related to or derived from nature is called natural. Though in a different sense, nature is also the essence of a person or an animal and can refer to the characteristic behavior or personality of someone. Similarly, another context in which we use the word natural is when something is quite usual or expected. Both words could be illustrated through the following example sentence. By nature, he is a wild and carefree man. Making mistakes is quite natural, which means usual or expected for him. The word unnatural would be the opposite of natural in this meaning. related words would be preternatural and supernatural, which are synonymous to an extent. We use the adjective preternatural to describe something that is beyond what is normal or natural. Like, the X-Men series of movies is about the so-called mutants, each with a unique preternatural ability. Though the word can be used in a milder sense to denote an extraordinary skill or capability of someone. Like in this sentence, he is an excellent orator with a preternatural sense of how to keep the audience captivated. The word supernatural would be one notch higher up than the word preternatural and would describe something that is so unnatural that it is beyond scientific explanation. Like ghosts could be called supernatural. Here is yet another example of the word preternatural. In the movie Planet of the Apes, we see that the apes develop preternatural abilities such as extraordinary brain development and agility due to genetic experimentation. Now, with a variation of the root spelling to NASC, NAS, the meaning would be being born. And a common word derived out of it would be nascent. Nascent is used to describe something that is just coming into existence and is beginning to display signs of future potential. Like here is a nascent or budding flower. But nascent is more commonly used for processes and organizations, like in the term a nascent industry. A related word is nascence, which is a noun, and an example sentence would be, the prospect of meeting our energy needs, majorly through renewable sources such as solar power plants, is still in its nascence. When we attach the prefix re to nascent, the word renascent gets formed and it literally means to be born again. The word renascent finds its use when something is becoming active or popular again. For instance, with the launch of the Indian Kabaddi League, the nation is enjoying the telecasts of a renascent sport that had earlier lost its sheen when compared to games such as cricket. And the related word, which is a noun, is renaissance, which is an extremely important term when we study European history. Renaissance period, mostly 14th to 16th century, is all about the revival of European art and literature under the influence of classical models. The style of painting, sculpture, and decorative arts identified with the Renaissance emerged in Italy in the late 14th century. It reached its acme or zenith in the late 15th and early 16th centuries in the work of masters such as Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo, and Raphael. Though by extension, Renaissance could denote a revival of or renewed interest in something, like in this sentence. With the entry of multiplexes, the activity of going to cinemas is enjoying something of a renaissance. And one of the common words which few people know is derived from this root is puny. The word puny is the phonetic spelling of puny, which means the spelling of how the word P-U-I-S-N-E is pronounced and has been adapted in English as such. Originally, puny referred to someone who was born later and hence a younger sibling. But nowadays, puny means small and weak. Like if you compare Hulk and a normal man, Hulk means a normal man seen puny in comparison. This is an action scene from one of the Hulk movies where you can compare the actual scale. The people who are jumping out are quite puny. And our last word is cognate, which literally means born together. In linguistics, cognates are words that have a common etymological origin. Like we can take the example of the words denoting a star in various Indo-European languages. These words star in English, tara in Hindi, etoile in French, stern in German, and stella or estro in Italian are cognates. Now test your understanding of the words learnt in this lesson by filling in the blanks below. It is recommended that you pause the video when the timer starts. And that brings us to the end of this video. Hope you liked it. Subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.